Sunday night at 9:30. Now on RTÉ One, the stage is set for an intervention in Shortland Street.
Trust me, mate. Tracy's not going anywhere except down that aisle on your wedding day.
It's all I'm living for at the moment.
Marrying me isn't going to fix things, and it's not fair on me to hope that it will. You need help, and if you don't have the guts to get it, then I'm sorry, but I really don't think there's going to be a wedding. Scotty, don't.
We should switch them on now, catch the warm-up interviews.
Boring, you'll drive away half the punters. See, if you wait until kickoff, they will get drawn into the game. It's all about psychology, man.
Look at that motley lot over there. What do you think they all have in common?
Easy. They all work at Chilton Street, and they've all come here to spend vast amounts of money.
Yes, and maybe, apart from that...
Well, they've been here 5 minutes and no one's ordered a drink.
Because they're trying to decide what other bar to go to.
What's wrong with this bar?
Okay, I'll tell you. They're all netball fans and they're all very excited about the World Series game tonight, but hello, your TVs aren't on.
They will be. Give us a chance.
You're screening the game.
Why wouldn't we?
Because you're blokes, who quite possibly only watch bloke sports.
Us? No way. We're far more involved than that.
Both my girls wore their bibs with pride. I'm a big fan.
Really? Well, that's great.
And can I just say, I love the way that the skirts that the Ferns wear get that little bit shorter every year. Netball is awesome.
Some of us are really hungry. If we're going to stay for the whole game, bus next, I'm going to do it.
Dinner menus.
Thank you.
Hey, you haven't seen Scotty at all, have you?
No, why?
We were having this massive argument and he just took off. I thought he might have come here.
Did he take a cell phone?
No, he was in too much of a hurry to get away from me.
Because?
Because he's still refusing to get help, and I told him that if he didn't, the wedding was off. And I meant...
So much for me talking him around. I really thought I got somewhere.
No, you did. He felt heaps better after talking to you today. It's just... That's the thing, every tiny step forward and he thinks he's cured again. And I really don't know what to do.
Hey, look. You've given him a big fright.
Yeah.
Okay. He's just out there walking it off. It's probably just what he needed to knock some sense into him.
Well, so Scotty we're talking about, though, he doesn't exactly respond well to ultimatums.
Gentle persuasion doesn't seem to work either.
Yeah. Sorry to bother you.
But where are you going now?
Home. See if he's turned up.
What if he hasn't?
Then I will really start to worry.
Hang on.
Hey, I'm not interrupting dinner, am I?
No, no, the boys are just clearing up. Come in.
Hey, Phoenix. Harry.
Hi.
Harry, could you get Scotty a glass of water, please?
Thanks. I ran most of the way.
You're exercising again, that's good.
Yeah, another plus for coming off the drugs. I didn't feel like it before. It's
gonna drag you out for a game of squash. Now, we'd be lucky to get a court.
I ran past the place. There's no one there.
That's quite a circuit you've done.
Yeah, I'm not really dressed for it either. I was out for a walk and the mood hit me. So if we're gonna go, I'll need to borrow a pair of shorts.
Think I can stretch to that?
Go. I can look after Harry.
But I've hardly seen you guys since I got back.
You're looking for an excuse to avoid a thrashing.
Think about all the dessert you just ate.
They're right. I need the exercise more than you do. Shorts.
Ah, I think I found the source of the Legionnaire's disease.
Come on, it's not that bad.
I'm sure you lived in places like this when you were a student?
Yeah, worse.
Oh. Note from Dan. He's gone out.
Oh, that's okay. I'll catch him another time. But when you do see him, can you tell him I'm sorry? I shouldn't have called him a thief.
It really wasn't him that stole the files from me. He did come with me to the vineyard, though.
Yeah, about that.
He did nothing wrong. It was me who...
No, that's not what I meant. You seem pretty convinced that those soil samples are going to test positive for Legionella.
Well, it's a bit of a leap, but it makes sense. I mean, the vineyard's right smack in the middle of the area.
True. A few hours ago, you were convinced the same place was riddled with pesticides.
Well, my mate at uni's retesting the samples as we speak, so we should know first thing in the morning.
Okay. Call me when you do.
I bet you $20 they come back positive.
I'll say the odds are in my favour. You might be grateful I'm not a betting man. See you, mate.
See ya.
Maybe ask your netball mates, they may have seen.
Thank you. You guys are missing a good game.
Yeah, yeah, looks like it. Hey, I don't suppose you've seen Scotty, have you?
No. Is everything okay?
I just can't track him down.
If you see him, give me a call.
Sure.
Here we are, ladies.
Excuse me.
Is there somebody I see?
No, don't be silly.
She still makes me nervous, can you tell?
She likes you. They both do.
Evening.
Pardon?
Oh, sorry, I was just about to do that.
No worries. Pour us a couple of vodka and tonics, will you?
Yeah, sure.
Busy night.
That's the TVs. $45.50, thanks. See, they're paying for themselves.
All right, I'm convinced.
You're a rowdy lot. I'm surprised we haven't had complaints from the dining room.
Oh, I have a complaint. The screens are too small.
Well, if they're any bigger, you wouldn't be able to see the bar.
Oh, we'd find a way.
Turn the volume down a notch, eh?
Where's the remote control for that lot? What can I get you?
I've got one waiting. Brody bought it for me.
Still surfing out, good lad.
Bella will have to drink it for me, though. I need to pick up the kids from the movies.
Movies on a weeknight?
Oh, it's more a treat for Jazzy, really. She was so miserable after the oral surgeon today. So will you be when you see the bill.
How much are we talking?
We're going to be paying it off for months.
Nah, we'll scrape through somehow. As long as Brody keeps buying your drinks.
Sorry, I had to quit so early. I thought I was fitter than that.
You've been unwell. What's my excuse?
I'll chuck these shorts in the wash and get them back to you tomorrow.
No hurry.
Scotty, I've been looking everywhere for you.
Had a game of squash with Chris. Now it's time for a shower and bed. Thanks for the ride home.
No worries.
Night.
Night. We just came from your place. Phoenix told us about Scotty turning up. I tried calling on your phone a few minutes.
It's upstairs on my bedside table.
It's okay. I felt a lot better as soon as I found out he was with you.
What's happened?
They didn't tell you.
He didn't say much about anything.
Huh.
Are you all right?
No, she's not. Something's got to give.
Hey, how much longer is that Netball World Series thing on for?
3 days.
Woo-hoo. Two more Boomerites for us. We're going to be rolling in it.
Last night was a one-off. Doesn't mean it's going to happen again.
Why not? That hospital crowd will be back.
Till they find somewhere with a bigger screen.
Nah, that was a joke. You know what Nicole's like.
She wasn't the only one. And I could tell Callum McGree he had his thinking face on.
What are you doing?
Well, I can't make the screens any bigger, but I can move them closer to the punters.
It's a good idea, Murray. I saw a few cricked necks last night.
Coffee? Machine's just warmed up.
Thank you. You all right up there, mate?
Yeah. No, I've got it.
Oh, are you all right?
I forgot how awkward the blasted things are. Sorry.
Ah, that's why we got insurance.
Yeah.
Well, this gives you a chance to upgrade.
Hey?
Well, you're talking about getting a bigger screen. Why not get one?
I suppose we could.
Well, I'd be careful if I were you. I mean, 20 more centimetres, what's that in cash across the bar? I mean, people aren't going to start buying bigger drinks.
Yeah, well, I say take the risk. Gives you a chance to replace them all, eh?
Is a poor student here?
I'm paying. Yeah, and who's the poor student who would have been down $20 if you'd taken his bet? At least let me buy you coffee.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks. So how did you know I was wrong?
I didn't, but I couldn't see why the vineyard was more likely to be contaminated than anywhere else.
So what do we do now?
Have you told the council?
Yeah, but they'll only make a move if they know for sure, and all they've got at the moment is some jumped up med student telling them there might be Legionella bacteria somewhere. He doesn't know exactly where.
He's got a jumped up head of ED supporting him. That might carry some weight.
If we wait 3 weeks for a confirmed case, that's how long it'll take, right?
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, people are still getting sick. A lot of them old people too.
That's what really hit me, the number of pensioners.
Well, there's the Blue Rose Vineyard there. The trouble spot's got to be somewhere close.
Probably somewhere where there's water, a reservoir or something like that.
There isn't any.
What's that?
Sports field.
I know. What's that at the other end of it?
It's a pond that looks like the size of a puddle. You can barely see it.
Well, unless you're way over here on the other side of the table looking at the map upside down. Do you know how to get there or do you need me to navigate?
What happened?
I got a bit excited and jumped off the wall. I dropped it. It's a piece of rubbish anyway. Wait till you see the new ones. Twice the size.
Oh, now it makes sense.
What does?
Oh, Cullen was talking to some of those scary DHB people, and he said something about bringing them over here to watch some big game on the giant screen. I thought, that's a bit of a fib. Most of them probably have bigger tellies at home.
Which game was that?
I don't know, but it's on this weekend.
Brilliant.
Thanks, sweetie. Bye.
What does he think we are? Party Central.
What are you going to do?
Oh, the man wants giant TVs. He will get them.
And how are you going to afford that?
Good question. Let me know if you've got any bright ideas.
I'm sorry. Is that what you're waiting for? We both said some things last night that we didn't mean.
Scotty, I meant every word.
You don't want to marry me.
You know I do. But marrying me isn't going to fix what's wrong. You have to take responsibility for that. I can't do it for you.
I'm not asking.
Yes, you are. And it's not fair. I want a husband. I don't want a patient.
Morning.
Hey.
Why'd you guys even bother going home if you were planning on coming back so early? You could have stayed up all night plotting. Tracy, you could have made your breakfast.
Do you want me to stay?
Not if you don't want to.
Okay, I'll see you guys later.
I believe this.
I called your psychiatrist this morning.
Well, you wouldn't have got him. He's away on holiday.
He's on holiday, but he's not away. His home number wasn't hard to find. He was planning on spending the day in his garden. But when I explained the situation, he said he'd be at his office by 11. I said, that's fine. We'll see you then.
We?
I'm coming with you.
I'm not going anywhere. It's none of your business.
We're doing this for Tracy as much as for you.
There is an element of self-interest. I haven't been to a good wedding in a while. I want to make sure it happens. Don't you?
Mate, you said something yesterday. You said you were the man Tracy got engaged to. Big, strong Scotty, always in control, never needs help from anyone. That guy, right? You think that's the guy you need to be? Well, it's not true. Because the more you try to be that guy, the bigger the mess you're going to make. And the way things are going, Tracy won't be there to pick up the pieces. Neither will anyone else.
We're in the right place.
I don't get it. Where's the pond?
Copyright Smartway Media, 1999.
Yes, a lot can happen in 11 years, and the kids who used this playground weren't even born.
I wonder when it was built.
When the pond dried up, the council drained it. Who knows? This might have been Ferndale's big millennium project.
Do you reckon it's still worth taking samples?
It's a long shot. I can't see the bug still being here when the water source is gone.
Well, there's no other pond in the area. Nothing.
I think I've cracked it.
What, another TV?
I'm glad you can still make jokes.
Well, it's laugh or cry, really, isn't it?
Look, the way I see it, we've got two options. One, we use the insurance money, we hire a couple of big screens and we rent them out to the IV.
Until the insurance money runs out, then what? More debt we can't afford.
So here's plan B. Same deal as now, we buy the TVs outright.
Do you know how much those things cost?
Two for $3,000.
$3,000 each should be more like it.
Oh, it's all sorted. Cash deal. The guy must have liked my face.
So where's this magic $3,000 coming from?
Well, I have to dip into the house deposit again.
No. No way.
Well, you come up with a plan then.
There's only one that I can see working, and that's telling Callum the truth.
Oh, right.
Tell him I lied to him for financial gain.
Well, it's not like you've been ripping him off. It's no skin off his nose. Who owns the TVs?
He'll fire me. I know he will.
He can do that any time he likes till your 90 days is up. He doesn't need an excuse.
Why give him one? Look, I like that job. I want to hang on to it.
We're not touching the house money again. I'm sorry.
You're wasting your time.
Probably.
And one of us has to go to work. If you come now, we'll still have time to go to the council office. Tell them what we know and leave them to it.
Okay, you win. Whoa! Holy moly!
What they're connected to is what I want to know.
What? Underground tank, you reckon?
Must be.
It's a popular place too. Maybe this is where the pensioners come to get sick.
Hey, how'd you go? Oh, they look like the other ones.
Oh, same family, different drug.
And no bad side effects, we hope.
I'll let you know.
Where are you going?
Need to lie down.
I don't think he got much sleep last night.
Before I forget.
Thank you.
How was he, really?
Good. Better.
Yeah, we've been here before, though, haven't we? Once he's been to 2 psych appointments in a row and I've actually seen him take the pills, then I might start to believe.
I was starting to think we were both mad. Then, as soon as we saw the sprinklers, we thought vaporised water, airborne bugs, maybe we're onto something after all.
What did the council chap have to say?
Well, he was pretty cagey till he realised we weren't pointing the finger. And it's not like we actually proved anything yet. They want to do their own tests, of course.
It seems you've ticked all the right boxes. Well done.
Well, you know what? I'd love to take all the credit, but I was only the junior partner. Thanks.
That's great. I feel so much better about stealing
the... Babbitt, Maxwell, take a seat.
Take this one. I have to go anyway.
Cheers.
Hey, son. I hear you've solved the Legionnaire's mystery.
Well, we won't know for sure until the results come back.
But he's looking pretty smug anyway.
What do you reckon, Maxwell? Do you think he deserves another chance at the research project?
Well, I don't know. Will that mean lifting the ban, letting him roam freely through the hospital again?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. Yeah,
you see, personally, I think we should ban all smart-ass med students. I mean, they're going to take our jobs one day anyway. I mean, why encourage them?
That's a bit late to think about that. You're a big help today.
I'll listen to him. Now I'm the help.
Hi, Dad. I said, hi, Dad.
I heard you the first time. What do you want me to do? Leap up and throw my arms around you? Look, you're in here 10 times a day and it isn't to see me. Your boyfriend's over there. Wendy comes looking for me, tell her I've gone to the bank.
Hey, I wouldn't take it personally. He's been in a foul mood all day.
Why?
Not sure.
I can't tell when you're lying, you know.
No, you can.
Look me in the eye and tell me you don't know what's wrong with Dad.
I don't know what's wrong with your father. Doesn't he know he's got the most beautiful girl in the world for a daughter?
Don't change the subject. Is it something to do with money?
You're really good at this.
Pretty safe guess knowing my family.
All right, well, don't tell him I said anything, but it's about the TVs. Your dad owns them. He's been leasing them to the bar, but told Callum they're from somewhere else. Now Callum wants to upgrade the screens, only he can't afford to do it. He doesn't know what to do.
And he's too proud to tell Callum the truth.
Too proud or scared, I don't know. Probably thinks he'll lose his job. Side effect.
Really?
No, this isn't the drug, this is me.
Hello, you.
Cheers. Are we okay?
We will be.
One step at a time, eh?
That's how I intend to do it. All the way down that aisle.
I'm starting to worry about you. Don't you have any friends your own age?
Why are you going to be like that?
Hey, come in. Come in.
You don't have to rip into them now. Share it with Dan.
Sweet, I will. Thanks.
Yes, you probably own a cold drink as well.
Yeah, maybe I do.
Mm. Getting people on side like that takes some passion, buddy.
I suppose I was pretty fired up.
Like trying to make amends for that patient with the cerebral bleed when you fell asleep on the job.
No, it wasn't that. Why does everyone say that?
Because we've been there. Look, we all feel responsible when we lose a patient. What if I'd done this? If only I'd done that. It never ends. But we can't run around trying to compensate every single time. If we did, we'd go mad. And if you want to be the great doctor that I know you can be, you need to understand that. Okay?
Okay.
Good. Well, that's me with my mentor hat on. Anytime you need me to drag that one out.
Oh, I've got something for you too. A USB full of highly confidential patient files.
Wonder how they got here.
I have no idea, but I thought you might want it back. Table for one. Take your pick.
Oh, I wanted a word with Murray, actually.
He's out. I'm not sure where.
Well, if he comes back with a couple of widescreen TVs, I'll be very happy. We'll need them by Saturday. I've been talking this place up.
About the big screens, I'm not sure that's a happening thing.
Is there a problem with the lease?
You could say that.
Come on, Brody, tell me.
It's not really my place to say anything, but there is something you should know. Where's Callum?
Bella said he'd be here.
Dining room,
thanks.
I mean, you understand why he wouldn't want to say anything. He's leasing his own TV, he's pretending from somewhere else. It doesn't look good, does it? And I'm telling you, there's no way he's getting those big screen TVs. He's barely got enough cash to feed his own kids, let alone deck this place out the way that you want it to be.
Keep talking. Twist the knife a bit harder. Go on.
Next today here on RTE1, dark family secrets come to light in Doctors. That's on the way after the break.